Children, how are you all? Are you all happy? Yes. I'm so happy to welcome you all to watch this video. In this video, we are going to learn science. This video is for class 4 ICC children. Lesson 11, part 1. Session 24. The topic is weather, seasons, and climate. We already discussed this lesson in social about weather and climate. Let us also learn more about in this video. Weather means how hot, cold, sticky or rainy a day is. We can also say that the weather of a place on a day is a condition of the air around the place on that day. When the weather is somewhat the same over weeks, we call the time a season. And the kind of weather a place generally has is its climate. Why do seasons change? And why are climates different? We'll see in this video. First we'll see why the seasons change. Think of an orange. It is a bit flat at the top and bottom and bulging in the middle. Bulging means little bigger than the top and bottom, and that is what the earth is like. Now imagine a circle going around the middle of the earth like a belt. We call this imaginary circle the equator. Spell the word equator. E-Q-U-A-T-O-R. Equator. The equator divides the earth into two halves. The northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere. We are in the northern hemisphere. See, in the right hand side, you can see the picture, northern hemisphere, southern hemisphere. Here, this is northern hemisphere and this is southern hemisphere. We are here in India, we are here. We are in northern hemisphere. This line, the imaginary circle, the white line is called as equator. E-Q-U-A-T-O-R. Equator. Okay. Next, you can see push a knitting needle through a rubber ball and let it pass through the other end. Hold the top of the needle, tilt it a bit and turn the ball around. This is the way the earth rotates. Rotates means moves about an imaginary line. We call this imaginary line the axis of the earth. The axis passes through the northernmost and southernmost point of the earth. These two points are called the North Pole and the South Pole. Okay, you can see in the picture, first picture, by pushing a knitting needle through a rubber ball and let it pass through the other end, okay, and hold the top of the needle and tilt na enna pannom saachukonu konjam, okay, tilt it a bit and turn the ball around, okay, rotate the ball, and this is the way the earth rotates about an imaginary line. We call this imaginary line the axis of the earth. You can see here the axis line, okay, from South Pole to North Pole, imaginary line, okay, and this is the axis passed through the northernmost and southernmost point of the earth, okay, and these two points are called the North Pole and the South Pole. Here you can see North Pole and South Pole in the picture. And next we'll see. You know that the earth does not only rotate about its own axis. It also revolves around the sun. It goes around the sun. Okay, the path the earth takes while revolving around the sun is called its orbit. Seasons change because the earth revolves and because the earth's axis is tilted to its orbit. Okay, why the season change? Season change because the earth revolves, moves around the sun, and because the earth's axis, you know what is mean by axis? Axis is tilted to its orbit. Okay, these two things make different part of the earth tilt towards or away from the sun at different position in the orbit. Okay, this makes season change. You can see in the picture, we'll see what happened in June, March, December and September. Okay, first we'll see what happens in June. Okay, in June, the northern hemisphere here, northern hemisphere is tilted towards the sun. Sun rays comes from here. You can see direct rays fall on a small area and heat more. Okay, so you can see the drawing and you will see the see that more of the northern hemisphere is in the sunshine than in the shade here. So here you can see the shade here more sunlight. So as earth rotates, places in the northern hemisphere remain in the sunshine longer. That means the days are longer than the night. This side night, the shade picture, and here days, bright side. Okay, the brighter side is day. So the that means the days are longer than the night in the hemisphere, in the northern hemisphere. So more sunshine means more heat. So the northern hemisphere becomes warm and has summer. Okay, understood? Next we'll see the southern hemisphere is tilted away from the sun in June. Okay, here the southern hemisphere down. The southern hemisphere is tilted away from the sun in June. So it has shorter days and longer nights. Okay, shorter days means less heat. Also, the earth's tilt makes the rays of the sun fall at an angle over southern hemisphere. These slanting rays spread over a large area, giving less warmth. So shorter days and slanting rays bring winter to the southern hemisphere. In the northern hemisphere, the rays of the sun fall more directly, vertically. So they fall on a smaller area, giving more warmth. You can see in the picture here. Okay, southern hemisphere. Okay, slanting rays spread out and heat is less here in the southern hemisphere. So days are shorter here and nights are longer. Okay, and next we'll see the activity. Okay, one activity is given. This activity will show how direct rays give more warmth than slanting rays. Hold a piece of paper directly in front of a torchlight. Torch. Turn on the torch so that there is a circle. You can see here a circle. Okay, circle of light on the paper, and then tilt means konja saachikano. Tilt the paper, the slanting rays from the torch will light up little bigger. Okay, bigger area, but the light will be dimmer here it will be bright and here dimmer than the circular patch of direct light. Okay, and you can when you are free you can do this activity. Next we'll see what happens in December. In December, the northern hemisphere is tilted away from the sun. Okay, this is sun rays and it is tilted away from the sun, so days are shorter than the nights in the northern hemisphere. Okay, the southern hemisphere, which is tilted towards the sun, has longer days and shorter night. Okay, the way the earth tilts makes the rays of the sun slant across a northern hemisphere, shorter days and slanting rays bring winter in the hemisphere, northern hemisphere. In the southern hemisphere, longer days and the direct rays of the sun brings summer here. Okay, next we'll see in March and September what will happen. In the March and September, in March and September, no part of the earth tilts more towards the sun, so the two hemisphere gets the same amount of sunshine. In March, the northern hemisphere has spring and the southern hemisphere has autumn. Autumn season means all the leaves will fall down from the trees and plants. And in September, in the north has autumn and the south has spring season. Spring season, you'll get new flowers, new leaves during this March month. Okay, you can see in the picture here it is given how the month, I mean the season will be in the March and September. Okay, here you can see in March and September, here directly no part of the earth tilts towards the sun. Okay, so the two hemisphere, northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere, gets the same amount of sunlight. Okay, sunshine. So in March, northern hemisphere, here northern hemisphere has spring and the southern hemisphere has autumn season. So in September, the northern season, northern hemisphere, north part has autumn season and the south part, southern part, southern hemisphere has spring season. Okay, go through this lesson and next video we'll see why climates are different, and we'll see the height of places and wind and rain, and how the climate affects plants and animals. Okay, thank you children. Go through the lesson and underline the new words you have learned in your book in this lesson, and try to learn the new words. Understood children? Thank you all. May God bless you all. Thank you.